Today I want to speak to the people who are living in isolation. Maybe you think like because you are living in isolation, God has forgotten about you. Or maybe you think maybe worse that maybe you done something wrong. That's why you are living in isolation. But that's why I'm here. I want to let you know that you are in isolation because God wants you to heal. Because you are so precious to God that He wants to isolate you because He loves you so much and He has such a beautiful and bright plan for your life that He wants you to take like a time out from this world, and maybe a time out from people, because He wants to heal your heart, He wants to heal your memories, but most important is that He has very big plan for your life, a very big plan. But because He has a very big plan in your life, He needs to isolate you. He needs you just to be with Him. Because he knows in which area where you need healing. He knows maybe you need healing from your memories, maybe from the things that happened in your past, maybe your childhood. And God knows if you don't heal now, then He cannot take you where you need to be. Because if we want to go somewhere in life, we have to become healed. Otherwise, if we never get healed, then we are always broken people. And God says, I don't want you to be broken anymore. I don't want you to be a slave anymore from your sin or from your thoughts. I don't want these things. I don't want you to hold these things over yourself anymore. Because I died for you on the cross. I died for you that you can live freely as a child of mine. And that's why if you want to become a child of God, then we have to listen to God. So if you are in isolation now, then I suggest you to talk to God. Say to God, God, where do I need healing? Heal my memories, heal me from my past, heal me from the things what happened in my childhood, because darling, because the things in the past, we need healing from it. If we don't get healed from it, then we can never walk fully with God, because otherwise we are walking with God but we are still broken Christians. And if I am broken and you are broken, then we cannot help each other. And but if I have been broken and if I am healed, I can help you, because I can tell you know what, I was so broken, but you know what Jesus done for me? He did this and this and this for me, and He could do the same thing from you. He make from my mess, He make a beautiful message, and He want to do that for you too. He want to do that in everybody's life, but we need to take this time, I love to call it like a time out, but we have to know that God does this because He loves us. Don't think like, oh, I am living between like four walls and God has forgotten about me and nobody thinks about me. You have a Father in heaven who is obsessed with you. Like the number one job of God. You know what is the number one job of God is? He's looking at you. He's looking like, I think she's hungry. I think she's thirsty. I think my child is tired. I think my child is sad. I wish my child would talk to me. Or I don't like it if my child is sad. I don't like it if my child keep thinking about the past. I don't like if my child keep thinking about the thing that hurt her, because I am here, I am next to her, but she never sees me. God is always with you, but we don't see Him. He's like your big invisible friend, but He's never gonna leave, and He will never leave. Like you can never do something that will make God leave. No sin, nothing. He will always sit with you, and He will help you through the sin, because God's number one job is to make you holy. Because maybe I also used to think like this, like the world. No, I just want to be happy. But then God had to teach me, no, Christina, I want you to become holy, and that's so much more. So maybe you think I am not so happy at this moment, but that's a good thing, my darling, because now you are in a process of becoming holy. And just give everything to God. Give your heart to God and say everything to God. The more we talk to God, the more we get healed. It's like with Popeye. Every time when Papa eats spinach, he gets more stronger. And with us Christian, every time our prayer is our spinach. Every time when we pray, when we talk to God, it's like we are eating spinach. We get so much stronger because God will give us the wisdom that we need for the day.